Now let's talk about probably the biggest mistake that students make when they start the incomplete sentence section of the reading test. This mistake is pretty simple. They take too long on the incomplete sentence section. Remember, the reading test, you have 1 hour and 15 minutes to finish all three sections. So you have to be careful about how much time you use for each section. This is called time management. We have to manage our time well. Most students take too long for the incomplete sentence section. And then when they get to the last two sections, the passage completion section and the short reading section, well, they don't have enough time and they can't finish. A lot of students never finish the reading test. So the last 20 or 15 questions, they don't even answer. What we have to do is understand that we should try and do the incomplete sentence questions in about 30 to 40 seconds. So one question, 30 to 40 seconds we should use. Total for the entire section, really? 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes at the most? That's how long we should use for the incomplete sentence section. Because really, that last section, that short reading section, it's difficult. And we need a lot of time to do it. So remember, be careful of your time. Time management is very important for this section. If you want to improve your grammar ability and increase your vocabulary, a great way to do this is to read English books and keep a vocabulary journal. Now, when I say read English books, I don't mean you should go to the library and buy some big, difficult book that was made for native speakers like me. You should go to the bookstore and try to find a leveled English book. Now, a leveled English book is basically a famous story, you know, maybe Sherlock Holmes or some kind of famous story, but the book has been written again and they use simpler words and simpler grammar so that English students like you can understand the book easier. Usually these leveled English books have level 1 to level 6. Level 1 is the easiest, and then level 6 is the most difficult. If you can find these, it can really, really help you out a lot. Now, when you do read these books, you should try to understand around 65 to 90% of the book. If you understand more than 90%, you should go to the next level, like level 2 book. Then read that book. Again, if you understand more than 90%, go up to the next level, level 3. Now the opposite is true too. If you try to read, say, level 2 book, and you only understand 50%, well, that's probably too difficult, so you should go down to level 1. So remember, 65 to 90% understanding is very good. Now, when we're reading these books, of course, there's going to be some words that we don't know. And that's okay, that's normal. That's why we read the books, to learn new words. But one mistake that a lot of students make is that when they're reading and they see a word they don't understand, well, they stop and they get their dictionary and they look up that word in the dictionary. And they look it up and go, oh, okay, now I understand. And then they continue reading. This is not good. We don't want to do this. Because when you take the TOEIC test, you don't have a dictionary. And if there's a word in the TOEIC test that you don't know, you can't stop and use a dictionary. So we have to train ourselves to try and understand a word that we don't know by using the sentences around it or the context of that reading. So when you're reading a book, a leveled book, and you see a word that you don't understand, don't stop. Try to make a guess about what the meaning is for that word, and then continue reading. Then when you finish reading for the day, you know, say today I'm going to read 10 minutes, and you finish that 10 minutes, then go back and choose, you know, 5, 6, 7 words that you didn't know. Write those words in your vocab journal or, you know, a normal notebook. Then look those words up in your dictionary. Write the meaning in the notebook, and if you have time, write the sentence that you saw that word in. So the sentence that you first saw the word you didn't know that's in the book, write that in your notebook. And then if you have a little more time, try and use that new word and make a sentence by yourself. Okay? So let's review. There's a word that you don't understand in a book you're reading. You don't stop, you continue reading. You try to understand that meaning of the word using the context of the reading. Then, when you stop reading, you go back and you write that word in your notebook. Then, you look it up in a dictionary, you write the meaning, then you write the sentence of the word, that sentence that you saw in your book. Then, if you have extra time, try to use that word to make your own sentence. Now, we only want to do this for about 6 or 7 words each time we read. If you do it for 10 words or 15 words, you'll probably get tired and you'll waste time. It'll take too much time, okay? If you can do this, if you can constantly and continuously read these leveled English books and then write the words that you didn't know in your vocabulary journal, soon your grammar will improve and you will learn a lot more vocabulary words, and this can really help you. Now, one more note of caution. Be careful. Don't read too much. You know, this is something that we want to continue. So if you can, you know, in the beginning, try to only read 10 or 15 minutes a day. And if you can, try to choose the same time of day to do that reading. So before you go to bed, or, you know, during lunch or whenever, but try to do it the same day so it becomes kind of routine. It's like brushing your teeth. You do that every day, don't you? Well, we're going to read our English books every day. And then we're going to write the words that we don't know in our vocabulary journal. This is a great way to improve your grammar and learn new words. So good luck.